activity that I am doing that is actually having any kind of significant impact or not. It enables the reader to review the quality and worth of the study. From a methodology, it will be clear whether I am following the right procedure or not. Right? So if I am actually clarifying my methodology properly, then the user can also have full faith that this data that has been presented that is actually having significant impact on the organization or not. Next stage of your report writing is findings. Findings matlab inferences derived from statistical analysis. Whatever results you have received from your calculations, we need to draw the inferences out of it. So descriptive reports ke case mein kya hoga? We need to communicate effectively in simple language. We provide the discrete facts and describe the details of the findings. That okay, on the basis of this particular test, this is the outcome, and that outcome has to be also converted into simple language. We have to tell that okay, that result of Z test is showing this value, and because this value is like this, it will have an impact on this particular business domain. That is called descriptive report. Findings should be easy to understand and point out important findings. See, when your reader is checking your report, they may not be very much familiar with statistical formula or the mathematical formula that you have required. So they should be given the results in a way that they can understand it. So aap simple agar apne apna koi statistical tool lagaya hai, and the value of it, you need to define what is the importance of that value. So possible interpretations and applications are also suggested in the report. Aapke report mein pata laga ke bhai there are two variables which are having impact on each other. So you will define how the company has to actually understand it. You will tell that okay, the customer sentiment is negative because the product price is going on the higher side. The moment the prices will come down, the customer sentiment will go up. So that is the kind of findings that we need to explain on the basis of the calculation that we have done, right? Explanatory report is prepared according to any one of the three models, which could be hypothesis testing, focused argument, and structural mode. These are the three different modes in which you are going to prepare your explanatory report. We are going to discuss one by one. In explanatory report, hypothesis testing, we start with a hypothesis. We have some assumptions that we need to check with the data analysis, right? So it also shows how they are implied in the theory. When you have created a hypothesis, you need to support that hypothesis with literature review. You will tell that in the past studies, it was found out that this kind of situation is having this kind of probability. And that probability is actually written in the form of hypothesis. For example, if you are saying that how the customers are responding to the smartphones in the post-COVID-19 situation, तो मैंने कहा कि एक इमरजेंसी सिचुएशन आया, तो उसमें जब उस इमरजेंसी से जब निकल के आते हैं तो कस्टमर का बाइंग प्रेफरेंस क्या होगा स्मार्टफोन्स को लेके. सो उससे रिलेटेड आपने एक हाइपोथेसिस बनाया कि भाई पीपल आर मोर लाइकली टू बाय द हाई एंड स्मार्टफोन्स. दिस इज माय हाइपोथेसिस. व्हाई यू हैव क्रिएटेड दैट हाइपोथेसिस? बिकॉज यू हैव स्टडीड सम मोर रिसर्च पेपर्स दैट हैव बीन रिटन इन द पास्ट. ओके, so describe the methods to present the data. Finally, it judges the validity of the hypothesis in the light of research results. You will define whether my hypothesis is valid or not, right? So there are several tests. Depending on the requirements, you can do them. Chi-square test, money and time test, Z test, that can be used depending on the requirement, right? And level of significance, I hope you know. Yes or no? लेवल ऑफ सिग्निफिकेंस पता है?
यस सर.
व्हाट इज दैट? पी वैल्यू चेक
करते हैं. लेवल, यस सर, लेवल ऑफ सिग्निफिकेंस आइडेंटिफाइज द एक्यूरेसी ऑफ द टेस्ट, दैट हाउ मच वी वांट आवर टेस्ट टू बी एक्यूरेट, एज वी कैन टेक द लेवल ऑफ सिग्निफिकेंस टू 95% और मोर देन दैट अकॉर्डिंग टू द रिलेवेंस ऑफ द स्टडी.
ओ वेरी गुड. So there are multiple values on which you can I can define that my test is significant on this particular accuracy, right? मैंने कहा कि 99% पे होना चाहिए, 95% पे होना चाहिए या फिर 90% पे होना चाहिए. तो अकॉर्डिंगली वी कैन डिफाइन ऑन विच पर्टिकुलर लेवल्स वी आर गोइंग टू वेरीफाई आवर डेटा. कंक्लूडिंग सेक्शन माइट ऑफर सम रिव्यू एंड रीअसेसमेंट ऑफ बोथ हाइपोथेसिस एंड द थियोरी ऑल्सो. सो इन केस ऑफ एक्सप्लेनेटरी रिपोर्ट वी कैन एक्चुअली डिफाइन दैट ओके दिस वॉज माई हाइपोथेसिस, दिस इज माई रिजल्ट एंड दिस इज द असेसमेंट ऑफ इट. Next time, if somebody wants to identify some more relationship, they can actually do some calculations on the basis of new situation. In my situation, this hypothesis was created and this is the outcome. If there is any change in the situation, what kind of hypothesis can be created, that can also be put in the concluding section. Next type of your explanatory report is focused argument. So all the data seems to contribute to a single conclusion and support a single central proposition, right? So as an investigator, what I will do, I will do the calculation of all the data and I will try to identify whether my central argument has been proven or not, right? So what we are doing, investigator feels that the task is to win the assent of his readers to the general conclusion. As an investigator, we try to identify whether I can actually take the confirmation from the respondents that whatever I have actually started with, they are agreeing to it or not. Right? So what happens? You should not go into the detailed descriptions. Detailed, unnecessary elaboration should not be done. So we need to ask the questions depending on that central idea. Asking too many questions will actually distort your elaborations, right? Focused idea brings clarity and the audience can understand it in the minimum possible time. That is very, very important. When you are going for focused argument, ask the question only to that particular situation, right? Don't ask them 10, 20, 30 questions which may not be directly related to your central theme. Examination of evidences in terms of its bearing on that issue can also be made. So we can check whether the situation that I have analyzed, whether the problem that I have analyzed, whether it is having all kinds of evidences which are supporting my argument or not. Right? Line of argument is also very, very important. We need to define whether the point that I am going to verify here, whether it has been properly proven or not. What is the basis of creating that particular central idea? That is focused argument. Abhi tak clear hua ya nahi? Yes, please.
Yes, sir. Theek hai.
Yes, sir.
Ho gaya.
Next is structural model. Structural model. Most difficult conceptual framework to manage for the presentation of quantitative data. Many a times we are having lots of data with us and we try to create a structural model of it. And this model needs to have empirical relevance. Empirical relevance means which is supported by your primary data calculations. Right? So the model has to be prepared more logically because the data that you have collected, it is defining the relationships and dependencies. So depending on those outcomes, I am going to prepare a structural model that will actually showcase whole of the study, right? It considers implementation aspect. The report might first concern itself with the structural aspects such as number of personnel, at their position, goals, environment, and then consider all other aspects of the system. For example, I'm saying that I want to identify how the people are behaving in a particular situation. So for multiple types of roles, multiple types of gender, multiple types of designations, so we can actually define multiple categories. Okay, for first category of customer, these are the outcome. For second category of customer, these are the outcomes. Third category of customer, these are the outcomes. So what happens? We are actually defining a full structure on which I am trying to fit my findings of the calculations, right? Whatever formula I have defined, so that actually be fit in the form of a structural model. So these are the three major types of explanatory report. फर्स्ट वन वॉज योर हाइपोथिसिस टेस्टिंग, जिसमें हमने कहा कि हम एक पहले एक आइडिया लेते हैं, दैट आइडिया इज कमिंग फ्रॉम लिटरेचर रिव्यू, उसको वेरीफाई करने की कोशिश करते हैं कि हाइपोथेसिस ट्रू हुआ या नहीं हुआ, उसके लिए कुछ कैलकुलेशन लगाते हैं, कुछ जेड टेस्ट, टी टेस्ट और पाई स्क्वायर टेस्ट जैसे टेस्ट होते हैं विच आर एक्चुअली गोइंग टू हेल्प मी इन वेरीफाइंग माई हाइपोथेसिस. सेकेंड मैंने कहा फोकस्ड आर्ग्यूमेंट. फोकस्ड आर्ग्यूमेंट में देर विल बी ए सेंट्रल आइडिया विच आई नीड टू वेरीफाई विद द हेल्प ऑफ रिएक्शंस एंड रिस्पॉन्सेज फ्रॉम माई टारगेट ऑडियंस. ऑडियंस से हम बात करते हैं, उनसे पूछते हैं एंड ट्राई टू टेक देयर कंसेंट एंड टू चेक देयर ओन बिलीफ्स वेदर दे आर ऑल्सो सपोर्टिंग माई सेंट्रल आर्ग्यूमेंट और नॉट. थर्ड केस में क्या है, स्ट्रक्चरल मॉडल. स्ट्रक्चरल मॉडल के केस में वी आर प्रिपेयरिंग वन मॉडल विच इज एक्चुअली शोकेसिंग द आउटकम्स ऑफ माई रिसर्च, राइट. सो दीज आर द थ्री डिफरेंट मोड्स इन विच योर explanatory report can be prepared. Lastly, very very important, your bibliography. All kinds of bibliography, all kinds of references need to be properly checked. और ये at all जो लगाते हैं ETAL, that is very very important. बहुत सारे मैंने लोगों के देखे हैं thesis and that at all should be avoided. If the number of authors is very long, only then you can actually use at all. Otherwise, you should mention the name of all the authors in your bibliography, right? Because many a times there are two authors. One person is the researcher, the second one is the advisor, right? So we need to use the both names. Second, if writing about network or multimedia, use the network. Internet draft should be also marked as work in progress. Many times researchers will put their work in progress also, and you are quoting that in your report. So you should clearly mention that this is work in progress. Agar koi book ka citation aap de rahe ho, to uska publication year hona chahiye, right? Ki bhai main ye jo book maine use kiya hai, to ye kab publish hua tha, author kaun hai, aur publisher ka name bhi hota hai to dal de. ISBN number dalne ki zarurat nahi hoti hai. ऐसे ही जब आप किसी जर्नल को कोट करते हो तो उसका ISSN नंबर होता है, वो डालने की जरूरत बिब्लियोग्राफी में नहीं है. वी कैन सिंपली मेंशन द नेम ऑफ द जर्नल, ऑथर नेम एंड द टाइटल नेम, राइट. इट इज एक्सेप्टेबल टू इंक्लूड द URL. अगर आपने कुछ ऑनलाइन कुछ उठाया, ऑनलाइन कुछ मटेरियल उठाया है, तो उसका URL आप डाल सकते हो, दैट इज नॉट ए प्रॉब्लम. बट मैनी टाइम्स व्हाट द स्टूडेंट्स डू, उन्होंने कोई रिसर्च पेपर डाउनलोड किया IEEE की वेबसाइट से या किसी भी वेबसाइट से, तो उस वेबसाइट का भी URL डालना शुरू कर देते हैं. दैट इज अ बैड प्रैक्टिस, बिकॉज दैट रिसर्च पेपर हैज बीन पब्लिश्ड इन ए जर्नल, तो उस जर्नल को क्रेडिट देना जरूरी है, ना कि उस वेबसाइट को. ये बात समझ आ रही है? मैंने सपोज एक रिसर्च पेपर पब्लिश किया है, दैट हैज बीन पब्लिश्ड इन ए पर्टिकुलर रेप्यूटेड जर्नल. अब उसी को मैंने उठा के शेयर कर दिया, रिसर्च गेट करके एक वेबसाइट है, वहां पे मैंने अपलोड कर दिया. If you have downloaded my research paper from ResearchGate, so you should not mention ki yaar ResearchGate se download kiya. You should mention that this paper has been published in a particular journal, right? So that proper bibliography also is important. Okay? Bibliography can be used for the software for any other non-library material. There could be some company's reports, some white papers that have been used. अच्छा, ये जो बहुत सारे स्टूडेंट्स करते हैं, विकिपीडिया को बिब्लियोग्राफी में डाल देते हैं, दैट इज आल्सो अ वेरी वेरी बैड प्रैक्टिस, बिकॉज विकिपीडिया इज सिंपली अ ब्लॉग एंड देयर इज नो जस्टिफिकेशन फॉर एनी काइंड ऑफ कंटेंट दैट इज मेंशन्ड देयर, राइट. सो व्हाट वी नीड टू डू, वी नीड टू एक्चुअली गो टू द रेफरेंसेस सेक्शन ऑफ विकिपीडिया लिस्टिंग ऑल्सो. इफ यू हैव फाउंड आउट अ कंटेंट ऑन विकिपीडिया, गो टू द लोअर सेक्शन, वहां रेफरेंसेस में जाके आपको उसका सोर्स मिल जाएगा. गो टू दैट सोर्स and give that mention in bibliography that I have gone to a particular website. For example, KPMG ki website pe report tha, usko maine use kiya hai. Avoid long URL. Many a times people will go to simply the name of that website, they will simply copy the full URL. Ho sakta hai 2-3 page ka URL, 2-3 line ka URL hoga, pura pura utha ke copy paste kar dete hai. That should not be done. Simply mention the home page of that website if the URL is very long. तो जितना कॉम्पैक्ट होगा URL, that will make it easy for the readers. They can also go to that website and they can find out the relevant information from that URL also. With this, we come to